Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny, and today I'm talking Meso or MicroToxin. So a lot of people ask questions on this because you see it used in so many different ways. And as I've talked about, mesotherapy or mesotherapy is making a comeback in North America. And so it's natural, what's Meso Botox or MicroTox, and is it right for me? Those are common questions. To answer it, first we have to think about results. And that's one of the reasons that this hasn't taken off in our country, is because measuring results from MicroToxin is very difficult because it helps shrink pores a little bit, but it also helps with fine lines and wrinkles, and it's hard to capture that on camera. So when patients come back and say, I'm not sure if I saw a result or not, we can't say, look, here's the result. But for many people, they see it, they see great results, and it's taking Botox or any other neuromodulator, Xeomin or Dysport, diluting it down so it's not as concentrated, and in theory, placing it all over the facial region. Now, it will stop muscle movement and it will reduce pores, but obviously there's areas where it'll be more effective. Today, I'm gonna show you around the eyes. The other area it's popular is along the accordion lines or the area in the lower cheek where the lines form, but because of the muscles, we have a zygomaticus major and minor. If you were to treat them, you would look like you had stroke features with loss of movement in one side or both sides of the face. So by using MicroTox here, it helps avoid that because it's superficial injections. What we're doing here is we're treating meso Botox or MicroTox around the eye region. This is one of the areas that works well, and you can see I'm just using superficial injections in and around the eye, and I'm even treating underneath the eye for fine lines and wrinkles, and I'm going into the superficial fat but also intradermally as on my way out with diluted Dysport in this case. Now you see sometimes during that video, I'm moving the under eyelid or the lower lid up down and I'm letting it snap back. That's the old school snap test. If the lid showed lag or didn't come up quickly, we might not treat the under eye with regular Botox or Dysport because the lid would sag and it would look older and puffy. So I'm just testing. In this case, we had a good return to normal of that lower lid. With Mesotox, you can get away with a mild to moderate pore lag. So in other words, if you move the lower lid down and it was a little slower than normal to get up, you can get away with it because you're injecting superficially. So that's a little bit about meso Botox. The other way to do it is by stamping it or microneedling it. But in general, I find what people pay for the result, people aren't the most satisfied. So for some people, it will be great. The majority, they're not gonna see enough result for the amount of money they pay. If you have further questions on that, I know a lot of people do it different ways. Comment below, let us know what you do. Maybe your patients like it. We love to hear from you in the comment section. And stay tuned here to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.